Hey there, welcome back to another Brigandine LP. This is Brigandine Grand Edition, Caerleon's Let's Play. So we are going to move forward a little bit more here. We actually got to Hadrian. Let's show the map here for a second. One thing I want to do too is, I'm doing two different Brigandine things. This one is my own personal LP that I'll be playing. Nobody else is playing this with me, so this is my own thing. I have done this before in the past on my other channel, which I might start linking my other channel to this one, because some people that are watching some of the Brigandine stuff on the other channel still maybe may want to come here and see this, because I'm going to be posting pretty much most of my current Brigandine stuff on this channel, Veracity Trigger, so that's my intentions. What we did so far is we just kind of circled around, we kind of leveled up a little bit. And what I pretty much plan on doing, and also for the viewers that are wondering about, they're a little confused. I don't think a lot of them are confused, but probably a couple are, who I'm taking to the final Bulnoil fight. So pretty much what it's going to come down to, it's going to be two leaders here. So it's either going to be, these other two leaders, but Kai's definitely coming along. I'm going to make up Kai's team, probably will be consisting of this. This might be Kai's final team. We'll have to see what I can fit. Definitely I'm going to bring these two vampires, or vampire lords, Alucard and D. They're coming along. I'll probably bring Unibrow, my high centaur, and I may or may not bring one of these dragons, depending upon what I can fit. But the other two leaders I want people to vote for, and I just want to say real quick, because I wanted to kind of like get this out there as far as, what's been voted for, what hasn't been voted for. So let's look at what's been voted for. Okay, so Cierra, I don't have her here, but I'll just basically say it right here. So Cierra has one vote. Dinadan has two votes. So Dinadan here, I'm actually trying to level up a bit more. I will max him out. So he's closest to be, to being one of the characters in a fight with Bulnoil. Merriot, Millia, got a pick. I think that was like an either or, but if it's an either or, then I would probably put Merriot as the first one, since that was the first kind of pick. I do have Millia, so she is another pick too that you could pick for. Shutleis and Sheluna were kind of a pick, but I think they were scratched. There's a possibility for that, possibly. But Sahara was definitely picked, so basically the definite picks are Cierra, Dinadan, Merriot, and Sahara, as far as what I know for definite picks. If you guys want to vote again for these characters, one more vote will basically mean that Dinadan is definitely going to the final fight against Bulnoil. That's not a bad pick. It's going to be tough, because if you're coming from the regular Brigandine game, and you're looking at it like this, what's basically going to happen is that the regular Brigandine game, you become a paladin, you get triple white orbs. I think you go to triple white, and I think that's what happens, but or it's either double white or triple white or whatever. But Dinadan has two, as you can see, he has a white orb and a green orb, so he's pretty much he's gonna get just mauled by meteor dudes. It's not good. But yeah, he'll be fun to use, but it'll be a bit trying, because he could die pretty easily in that, because there's a lot of reds, there's a lot of meteor dooms. The Geno Thunders won't affect him too much. He has a pretty decent intelligence. 72 is good, for intelligence. But yeah, you just need to, vote. One more vote for Dinadan will lock him in, from a subscriber. So if you're subscribed and you're watching along and you want to guarantee Dinadan's in here, just do one more vote and that will pretty much lock it in. But if you want to have some more contention for other characters, definitely vote for other characters that I could possibly get. We can look at some of the castles and see what everybody has right now, but I can't guarantee, everybody's all set in place. So we'll see for that. And definitely if there's picks in here that I see, but I don't, I'm just about to beat the game, I just don't have, I just don't have the time to do other things, I'll take a knight that's been picked in here that's not a quested knight. So we'll kind of go that way. So that's what's there, nothing there. We'll just look at what knights are where and what, they have. So I'll look specifically, we'll see if there's any other knights. I could get Morholt, you know, killing off Vinard. That's probably the thing that you probably are interested in knowing too, what my next plan of moves is I'm not going to kill the queen. Not unless the queen is pretty much down to one castle. I'm probably definitely going right for Norgard. So this is going to look interesting and a bit odd in a sense, where I just go right for Norgard. So I'm not going through the Empire's territory. That's still a bit strong. I'd rather have them attack me on defense, hopefully. You know, hopefully they attack me on defense and I can hold out. We'll have to see. But yeah, some Hexus is here. So he could come in. He could definitely do some damage. Wait, what does he have for his other guy? So we're going for Norgard first. So if you want to pick the knights that you get from Norgard as one of my leaders that I take into the Bulnoil fight, that's another option. So Norgard's going to be the first one to go. Then it's going to either really boil down to either the queen or Drizzt. It's really going to boil down to, or not, no. What am I saying, Drizzt? Queen or the Empire. So here's the point of what my plan is. We're going to move through here. This is pretty easy to move through here. I mean, there's only three castles to get in Norgard's territory versus 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I'm in. So it's easier to get through the queen's territory to get to Norgard. I can help them out. I can pretty much block most of this stuff. You know, that'll make Lance a little bit strong here against the Empire. Then I can come down through the Empire's territory, help them out there, and possibly block Lance from coming down this way at all. So I could probably stop him here. Probably. And then Lance will probably find a way to come back here because the Queen will retake this territory. Then Lance will go through the northern area, and then I can come back and block Lance here and grab a ton of territory. So that's what I'm probably going to do. That I might be able to kill everybody off myself. But that's one of the ways to do it. So let's see if anybody could class up. I think, no, she's close. I got Shutleis on my team. Shutleis isn't bad. I mean, it would be a good choice. I got a good shield for him right now. Melia's here. There's a lot of choices you could go with. Even Shast. I mean, if somebody wanted to vote for Shast, you know, we could try turning him into something. Right now, I want to put him through the barbarian thing so I could get... I don't know. I don't know what extra skills you get with him, barbarian. Well, he already has a hit and run from the other one. Counter damage plus 10%. That would be good. You know, that would be good. I don't know if I'd fully go Berserker or fully go into the grappling thing. I'm not super happy about the grappling thing here, but, you know, just let me know what you think. Oh, and then was the other question, you know, was it Lilith, you know, I was going to convert to, or was it Lucifer? I mean, that's what we're used to, but now Lucifer, as far as his full English patches go, is concerned, has been changed to Arch Seraph. So now it's pretty much, if you haven't been playing, this is confirmed, you know, as far as a single player campaign, you get an Arch Seraph. There is no more Lucifer, it's an Arch Seraph. So it's two whites and one red. Two whites, one red. That's what it is. So the Arch Seraph still gets Meteor Doom, he still gets the black arts as far as, you know, what you can convert to. He still gets the wing attack that he normally gets, but he loses the black orb. I know it sounds silly. It kind of is silly in a way. I still would have preferred the other way, but that's the way it is here. It won't make too much of a difference, except for Meteor Dooms will hurt him a lot more now. So going into that final fight with a angel will be a little more detrimental. So I think I got everything through there. And as far as monsters are concerned, I know one of the subs that subscribed to me, Jordan Keck, he suggested. He was the one that was talking about Lilith or the Satan, but so far I have the item to fully convert to a Arch Seraph, which previously was Lucifer. So I have that item. I probably will work on that one. Some other ones were suggested, Scuba Steve, or what, you know, people might be confused. Who's Scuba Steve? This is Scuba Steve right here, my Triton. So I named him Steve. You know, if you ever had an aquarium where you had the little scuba man in there. I saw it in a movie once. It just sounded hilarious. And so, you know, the little scuba man in the aquarium, Scuba Steve. So that's what I'm calling that. Anyways, let's get to a battle. Let's move forward a little bit. I don't want to talk too much about it, but the other monsters are voted for is a High Centaur, a Fairy, a Lizard Guard, a Pegasus, and the Lucifer or the Arc Seraph. So besides Scuba Steve, those are the other ones that are voted for so far. If you want to keep voting for other monsters, possibly go right ahead. I'll see what I can fit. The ones with most votes will be in these slots here underneath the secondary leaders, but you also have to pick the leaders. So one more vote for Dinadan, guarantees he'll come. And a couple more votes for anybody else I've already suggested on the list, or if you want to vote for anybody else, that's perfectly fine. So, we did all that. Let's move forward. Not much else that I think I'm doing here. I'm trying to remember what I was going to do. I think I was going to bring a couple other leaders with me. I think Millia, Shutleis, and Biarte. I need to get an arc. I need to get an angel here and level up an angel. So, I'm going to get an angel. I might put it on Merriot's team. Oh, I did get a demon. I did order a demon. I thought I was going with the whole demon class. I mean, I might still get the demon item, you know, so we'll see about that. But let's put you here so I can put an angel up here. He's going to need something good, so that'll be okay. I won't start leveling up the demon right now, but I do need to work on a angel. So I need an angel on this team. Wait, what is in stock? Did I even look at stock? No. Okay. Alright, so that's... Can I quest anybody? I think I can. Oh, Shast, yeah. I'll quest Shast. Okay, let's move up to attack. The reason I'm not questing everybody else out right now is because I want them all with me. So when I get two here, I can do a double attack, and I can have two armies attack right away. I don't think there were any angels here I could buy. I kind of forgot to look at. I think it's rocks and, oh man, it's going to be terrible if I find out there's angels here I could buy. Oh yeah, Gloom does not. I know Talus does get angels, so I guess I'll have to get an angel when I get to Talus. I don't think I'm going to get anything else in the meantime, so I don't have to try leveling everything up ridiculously. Because of it, let's see what they got here. They just move there. The queen might actually attack me, believe it or not. This will not, because there's only two leaders available to attack. It's really based upon whether you see their names are grayed out or they're in white. I could attack the queen, but I'd rather be on defense for a team that I haven't really used too much yet. So let's just do that like that. Location, we'll go here. Alright, so basically, you know what the next attack is. It's the attack on Gloom. I'm just going to push forward the video right into the Battle of Gloom, right while we're fighting. So, you know, I can save some time that way. But I'll show you a little bit of what's going on here. Norgod retreated. Elmechia is doing pretty good. So they're getting a little bit stronger. That's a good thing. Empire took over my territory. That's fine. I don't mind. I'll be coming back soon enough. Norgard is pushing in here. Oh, man. Yeah, I think they're going to beat him. Because the queen is pushing too far south. She has her units spread out too much. Now she's going to be so far spread out. Oh, the queen is attacking me right now. So I guess it's going to be the Battle of Hervory Castle. So we'll see how my secondary team can hold up to this. It'll be a little difficult. They do have a couple rocks. I don't have much that can cure. I don't have anything that can cure up stoning. So this is gonna be crazy interesting to watch. All right. I will see you at the defense of Hurry, actually, instead. And in the next battle, we will do the attack. So try to fit in as many battles as we can in this LP, and we'll do it like that. So. Alright, let's start this up. So, I think I'll probably get hit pretty fast here. Okay. Okay, so I gotta sort of reserve that angel to heal up the Tiamat there. Reason I did that is because he gets a little bit of... I think it's hit. It's either hit or evasion, I'm not sure, but it's a bonus right now. I'm trying to remember that. It's the one thing that's hard for me to remember. But I'm putting these clay golems here just to defend against these rocks. And I'm glad they're hitting these clay golems right now. I'm just hope they just focus on a clear arms. Oh man. Well, I do have a cleanse with Biarte, so I kind of forgot about that. I kind of forgot Biarte gets. I thought he got like a halo spell or something, or maybe that's the woman, the female class. I'm not sure right now. But basically, oh man, I want more here before I start doing more damage. But there's not too much I can do. Well, if I can hit him. Man, that's right. They just don't hit hardly anything. Okay, so he's a little bit low. That might focus. That might make them focus on that. Hopefully, I can't put my scorpion in too much danger. But let's see here. What is optimal for me to do right at the moment? I think. Probably shooting this bird here, because I got a shot on him. That's the level 7 one. I'm probably going to get a hit here. So I get this thing down just a little bit. I think ultimately I could probably kill all these things off in one turn. But there is this to contend with too. So do I have enough for two wave attacks? That's the thing. Yeah, I could definitely kill them all off pretty fast. Well, I don't want to do a bunch of wave attacks right now. Because I can do Divine Rays. So let's just do a single flame spell, which is concentrate on these two guys, because these two guys are the strongest. This is pretty much the most tactical thing to do, I think. It's going to be the best thing I can do. I don't need too much more. I do have this thing going with a breath attack, a Divine Ray, and that should do it. Yeah, that should do it. Plus I have a dragon attack in case I really, you know, don't get it the right way. Let's just end with them. I don't want them getting too damaged or anything. Let's see, did anybody really need a health or a heal? This thing, sure, but I don't really need too many clay golems. I don't want to care them up right now. I'd rather them try to focus on this thing a little bit. So I need to get rid of these rocks. These rocks, I only have one person to cleanse. It's not going to be fun if I have to cleanse like crazy. So let's get rid of these rocks. The thing is, I'm still preparing for the rest of their army to come because I don't have everything perfectly set the way I'd love it to be. This could probably Geno Wave this away. I think that would be good enough. I think that should work. And Bilkak just doesn't have enough for a lot of magic, so nobody's super hurt right now. I think I might want to reposition here just so I could have him heal up the... Yeah, let's do that. Let's reposition him here. Okay, now they're going to come up. They're probably going to stay for a while because they have a dragon, they got the two griffins, and they got the phoenix. If I kill a couple of those other things off, then that'll change the dynamic of the battle. I know that for sure. The dragon is gonna get pummeled on. Hopefully he doesn't die. Oh boy, they put the phoenix there. If it criticals, that could do massive damage. Good thing it didn't. Alright, good. It's getting close. It's getting a little close. Hopefully they don't pummel everything into that dragon, then I might be alright. Now there's more things here for a Geno Wave attack, especially the phoenix. This is perfect for a phoenix. I do want to kill that thing, though. But the thing is, my breath attack might totally kill it off anyways. But I do need to do... Well, who should I level up? Sierra? Well, I think Sierra should be able to do 105. So, this is a lot. Let's go with this. I do need to get that phoenix in there, too. And I can worry about thinking about breath attacking over there. You know, breath attacking up to finish off the other thing here. This is getting a good amount. 150 on him. That's freaking perfect. So, yeah. I thought I'd at least do 105 on that other phoenix. So that thing's gone. I don't need to worry about that all that much. She's going to Holy Word. So 1, 2, 3... What does it go? 4 spaces? No, not that. Let's go 4 spaces. Oh, jeez. Yeah, that's going to hurt. But I do need to kill this phoenix off, because that's pretty much her... I know I'm... I mean, I need to get this thing low enough so I can start to work on it, but as soon as the turn rolls over, it's going to gain another 60-something hit points, whatever. It's going to be good. This should be enough to kill off this bird, I think. And, yeah, that should be enough for that. So he's up to level 5. He leveled up a little bit, so he healed up also. The other thing is, once I get close, I can bring the merman in, or I could just leave him here in case they want to fly around and attack the merman. He'll be attacking them on water, which is nice. So it's like plus 5. I think evasion is the second one, and the first one's hit. So it's plus 5 for hit, and then the evasion. So the Hydra gets extra hit ability. There's not too much more I can do. The queen kind of set herself in a good position here. If I can kill off this phoenix, that'll change the tide of the whole battle. So we'll work on that. So she has another wave attack, so I'll wave them all goodbye next time. I'll wave them all goodbye with this one. This should be a pretty fast battle, I think. So there's nothing more to do. Let's end that turn. Let's see what you're going to do. Charlene wants me in the front. Oh, that's fine. Oh, man. I could lose him. Yeah. Oh, 85? Yeah, they're going to kill it off, man. Yikes. There goes my dragon. Should have probably healed him up just a little bit. He was only down like 100 hit points, but even that could be enough. Oh, yeah, they're going to crit and kill him probably. Ooh. Well, they still have another archer, so I don't think he's going to survive. Unless they make some random turn and decide not to kill him. Oh, boy. What was that? This could be close. Wait, 12? And then 4. Oh, yikes. Yeah, he's pretty much dead. I can't save him. Because, I don't... Oh, I'm 5! Dude, yeah. I got this. I got this. I'm pouring heals into him like there's no tomorrow now. Jeez, this is going to be interesting. My Griffin will be a little low. I'd love to get a Holy Griffin out of this, but I'd also love to level up Janfurter as much as possible here. So let's go here. Let's guarantee the attack. Might be able to kill him off, because that other team's too far south. Yeah, that's going to hurt. Not too much I can do about that, though. Well, if I can poison him... I mean, let's see if I can level the Scorpion up a little bit. Yes! Yes! We got him! So, oh man, that's low. That did a lot of damage. These things are ridiculously powerful. Don't you agree? Don't you agree those things are a bit ridiculously powerful? 51, 47, it's a horse apiece. One's just slightly higher. Oh man, you'd think 51 would be better, but we'll find out. Let's try this. Nope, not that much better. So, I mean, evasion, you know, I mean, the random chance of what you decide to pick this and that can be all kind of weird and strange, but I don't know. Oh man, if I blow him away right away. Oh, but I am going right away, anyways. So, hopefully a couple heals will get the ball rolling in my favor. If the turn rolls over, the turn will kill him. That's a guarantee. You will see that happen. And a good thing about him, though, even though he's low, you could probably heal him up, too. Not too much. You know what? I'm not going to heal him up at all. No. If he dies, he dies. I mean, he's at 200. He doesn't get hit that much anyways. I know it's a Genoflame, but I do have... If I want to Divine Ray him, I can. Okay, so this is interesting. So either I go... hit all the enemies. That's level 10 now? Are you kidding me? How did it get level 10? What was it, like level 9 when it came here? That's ridiculous. Alright, so he's going next with this. Open a space here. He's gonna hit me here. I don't think the dragons survive, even with all the heals. I don't see it happening. I'm going to hit them all, but they're still going to stay. They're still going to stay. I know that for sure. I don't know if this will totally kill him, though. I feel like I need to throw a flame spell just to guarantee it dies. I'd love to do extra blast, but you know, this is like my last Genoflame. This is like all the magic power I have for him. This will do like 90. 90, then it's down to 80. Then it'll survive the next turn. And I'm 15. Oh, wait. She's 13, so Cierra goes at the beginning. Yeah, this will be fine. So Cierra will. So I'll go, then he'll go, and then Cierra. Yeah, this should be alright. Oh, wait a second. Oh, 12.
Oh, man.
Ah! I have to divine ray it. What am I thinking? Oh, man. Oh, that's only 69? Okay. Alright, well, I can have two cures go to it. I won't be able to. I won't be able to do too much. I could just attack it with the angel. Save some magic, actually. I might be able to just do that. So let's heal up the dragon as much as we can. I don't know if I'm going to get too much into it, but at least it won't get hurt. Yeah. Holy word. Attack. That's 100. We got to divine ray this thing. Get this thing out of here, because I'm going next. Oh, wait a second. Did I mess that up? Okay, so 5. 4. Oh, they're both 4. Okay, so yeah, she could definitely heal it up if I don't kill it. Yep. I keep thinking that. That she wasn't going to go. I don't know why I'm thinking that. Oh my gosh. Playing the whole other multiplayer is starting to mess me up. I gotta start focusing on this, you know, as far as getting something to go for me. So they healed that up. I'm at a decent health, but I think the dragon's still gonna die. I just kind of feel like it's still gonna die. I don't think I can heal it up well enough. Because there are 2 more attacks, 2-3 more attacks, and it's gone. I know that for a fact. Okay, so yeah, he's gonna kill that thing off. I wasn't too worried about that, really. Just kind of hoping they focus on the clay golems. I don't really particularly want clay golems. You can see how many times I already missed as it is. So it's not the funnest thing ever, you know, to keep missing like over and over again. So I'd rather have something like, even a giant I think hits more than that, so I'd rather have something like that if I can. Part of the reason I kept him there too is for stuff like that. So I will have to fill this space in. Probably he will have to come and attack it, which is not the funnest idea, but we have to. Just start off with breath. Go from there. Queen could stay. She could possibly still stay, but as long as I kill enough or high enough, you know, strongest monsters off. I don't know. Well, it's gonna be risky if she really wants to. Okay, I got up to 7. Nice, nice, nice. Can I get a hit? I'd just love to get a hit. Oh man, it's gonna be risky. Oh boy. Okay. I'd love to get this out of the way, but I have to keep him here. And he's probably gonna die still. Well, I might be able to kill her. Let's see. I'd love to hit the queen. She is a green, but she's got a lot of hit points right now, and this one does not. So maybe I can get something going here. We'll have to find out. Well, that would definitely kill that, but she's also super weak. Let's see how low I can get everybody. I will kill off this djinn. That's important. I do have to kill off this djinn. She'll still have a good amount of magic points left, so I could probably still do another attack, maybe a venom. Maybe a couple of venoms would be the best for now, because there's a lot of white still left. So I got that. She's up to 16. She is incredibly low. Oh boy.
I think they'll kill this thing off.
Exactly?
Wow. All right. So she retreated. Okay, so I lost a couple things. Not too worried. Oh, Janfeder, I gotta level you up, buddy. I really do here. I don't know. 34. Is there something that's really worth going for the kill? Like, I don't want to lose this dragon, really. Is that low enough? No, most of my stuff is pretty weak. I don't wanna tempt fate here. That just would not be a good idea. Let's get a little easy shot on something, but I don't really know what to hit. Just go for this thing. Let's see if I can get that to go. Okay, good. Get some experience. I want to level up my wizards ASAP. So that's what I'm hoping for. This is fine right there like that. I think... Oh no, he's going to die if I move him there. Got to save the scorpion fun. This should be a safe spot. And venom. Should be enough. Quite literally. So if they still want to stay, I have more magic. I have more magic. So this is perfect. So tiny little spell, 34 hit points is to do something like... I was going to say 50, but 100. Okay, perfect. Perfect. 100. Wow, I was way off on that mark. Let's move you down here just to keep her from getting hit, because here's the thing. These two open spaces, that could allow them to move in here. But blocking it like that? No, they won't. He needs to protect that centaur a little bit. Okay. I don't think the centaur will die. He's at full hit points still, so he's still pretty good. I did a good amount of damage. I mean, I really, really did, so I'm really happy I did that. can you go kill something, be our Billcock? Nope. What if I have him go attack the centaur? Let's see here. So he's got two strong things that are going to hit me. He will retreat. Unicorn, doubt, or really do much. Where can my other angels go? That's important to know. So I could go there, and he could go there. He can go here. So this could work. But where's my hit points on that one? So he's halfway low. He's a bit lower. Oh, I could lose an angel this way, though. Yikes. Alright, so that might not work the way I thought it would. Let's just heal up the front lines. I want to, but then if the angel's down to 200-something and they pump, you know, a griffin... well, griffin will do about 80, but the dragon could crit for something more. Maybe kill it. They do have a unicorn that will rush in there to do something, too. Don't want that to be the thing. I did get to save the dragon. I lost a clay. That's fine. Not too worried about that. If I can get a wyvern instead, that'd be perfect. Let's see what I can heal. Well, he's in a corner. He's good. Let's heal him up. Okay, so that's the end of this battle. That defense, it almost looked like it was going to be a little bit tough there for a second, but then it got a little bit easier, so... Yeah, so there's nothing else to attack besides this centaur. Well, I forgot about the other centaur. Yeah, they could kill that thing. If they really wanted to, they could kill the centaur. But, or will that do it? Oh, man, yeah, that will just flat out kill him. All right, so I lost a centaur, man. Lost a centaur, lost a clay. What else did I lose? Oh, the merman, he died too. I don't really need a merman, though. It was just what I had in stock. Half the time I'll just throw something I have in stock in there. We saved the scorpion fun. That's the important part. All I really have to do is defend here. I'm not worried about monsters when, you know, lost. I'll lose all my monsters to defend, especially for something like this. I have to hold this, so I don't really care. It's not a big issue. I think I get angels here, so I might order another angel, but I don't know. That's a little risky, possibly. So this is the next battle we're going into. I'm taking Kai, Merriot, and Dinadan. You know, be sure to still plug your votes in as far as who you want as the final two extra knights. But we'll get into this battle here, and I'm going to pause the video and jump right to the battle. Okay, so you can see the battle's already starting here. I forgot about the centaur there, but the centaur came out to shoot me, and so that pretty much initiates the battle. And so here we go. I wanted to get Scuba Steve out there, but he's still pretty far back. So let's move up here, do some easy shots. This will be somewhat of a land battle. I wanted Scuba Steve out there. Let's see if we can get Scuba Steve out there. Let's give that a shot. Let's try that out, see how it works. But where though? He has to cross forest. Let's just move you there. Let's see. Oh, that doesn't work on our team. Yeah. All right. So I gotta change the fairy to Kai's team. Actually, I'm just gonna have to use her for. I'm just gonna have to do it that way. That's the way I have to do it. Save me, scorpions here. So we're gonna save them all the way. Whole way through the game, hopefully they'll survive the Bulnoil fight and the Snake of Chaos fight. That one's going to be chaotic to watch, to see. Where can you go, little buddy? You know what? I might be able to get Scuba Steve out. I might. Yeah, I think I can. This would be cool if I can. Let's go you right there. And no one's really attacking. I don't mind Mary getting hit because I need her to level up. So I got one space for her to get hit. Not much else. Well, they do have an archer. They do have some other stuff. Oh, boy. I guess I have to form a line. She is, I mean, she's not super weak, but I don't want her getting amazingly weak. You know, possibility. They do have a djinn. They do have a centaur. Something ridiculously strong hits her. I'm just a little worried. Maybe I'm a little paranoid, but I want to make sure things going to turn out okay. Let's move just going to get up there. I want the vampire near the water. It's not the most beneficial thing, but it's the thing that's going to work for me. I'm going to move him there. Actually, I'm going to go with both vampires over there. So, this doesn't look like it's going to stay if I try anything serious. Let's just do a little flame spell, get rid of this thing. I don't want to burn up all my magic. I still need them to get in here. So, that's good. 26. Nothing to burn down right now. Let's move you in here. Take a little shot on this thing. Boom! Get it out of the way. Once it gets here a little bit more. A little worried about him being out there all by himself. Just a bit. But, can't be helped. Cannot be helped right now. Do I have any healers over here? Not at the moment. Okay. So let's try that. That's fine with me. Go and whack him. Bam! Critical. Just like that. Just like I called it. Alright, you have to stay right where you are. Don't move. Don't move. Don't move anywhere. Just stay right there. So hopefully this will stay on him the rest of the battle. I'm not going to knock him down. I'm just going to kill off some of his monsters. This will be a good thing to do. I mean, I could. Oh, he's going to cure it up. Ah, dang it. Alright, so I want Scuba Steve to get some kind of damage going. I'd love to get a Poseidon. If I could just focus on that, you know, just focus on getting a Poseidon, that'd be amazing. I think you might get there with a lot of battles, but that and the Vampire Lords, I'd love to get them up there. So Scuba Steve, Dee, and Alucard are definitely coming to the final fight. That's what I'm going to focus on right at the moment. We'll see what else we can do. And I put Dinadan... Well, no, I took him out of the forest. But, whoa! Because it looks like they're focusing on Beowulf right now. 70%. Yeah. Bam! Let's try that. I get him a bit lower. It might try to hit him a lot. Snipe shot. So, well, that's 100%. Yeah, might as well give her experience. Hitting a leader is going to give her experience. 129, that's good. I like that. You know what? He's pretty low, but he's going to get double divine raid. He might just totally die. Yikes. So, let's get you out of the way. Make sure you don't come back. You're not going to hit me on water anyways. So, that's good for that. Ooh, I could go around. Do I get divine raid? No, I do not. But I will get surrounded. Where can my little scorpion man go? Oh, he can't. He can almost make it. If I could get him like that, then I'd surround him and hit him. But otherwise, I'm just going to do this. So most of their stuff is focusing on the giant. Actually, if I want to save the giant, I don't have much more to go. I'd rather have Kai do some attacks. I only have number 3 to heal him up, but double divine rays are going to blow him away. I'm going to try this tactic. I'm going to react him, move him out of the way. I just need to, you know, get him some hits, level him up. And we'll work it like that, so. Put you in the forest. That might save you a little bit. I know it's not probably the best thing ever, but I need to kind of save him, and I don't really want to heal him right now. I'd rather get Scuba Steve out here. Can I move further? No, that's as far as I can see he can go. All right, so let's do this. I like having the fairy, but ideally I need to have fairy on Kai's team for certain reasons. So who's damaged? Well, just a little bit, not much. Everybody's pretty much okay still. It's really just the giant. I do want him to fight still, but I needed to pull him away. I wasn't going to heal him, but I guess. I don't know. Maybe that wasn't the perfect thing to do, but a little worried about him, and you know, I know that she can do it, so. Plus, even that, just healing him up to this point, this many hit points, 2 divine rays, or divine ray and a holy word, you'll be dead. Centaur shots and djinn shots, that Beowulf will be totally dead. So there's really no point keeping me on the front lines right now. Just, I mean, yeah, it could happen to him too. I mean, it could happen to almost anybody, really, but gotta take. I want to go out the most cautious thing possible. Most cautious thing possible. Jeez. We will probably level him up. Just want to stick him here for now. Let's see here. Who's going in front line? So, okay. Alright, so this tactic should work. Oh, let's move this out of the way here. Should get you up there. Level 10. Nice. Alright, so we're going to move. Oh boy. Alright, so D's in the front lines. Who should I level? Yeah, D should be the one. He's a little bit lower. Oh, you can go right out on the water. Holy Word will do a lot of damage to him. I don't want him to be in the super front lines. Let's get him over here. I don't really know where to go. Oh, I could attack the bit. No, that would have been terrible. That would have been a terrible idea. Oh my gosh. Let's see if we can get rid of this angel here. I'm just trying to go for the most tactically available things, because, I mean, the thing is, like, you're probably like, oh, why'd you react him and move him out of the way instead of healing him up? This is not enough hit points to survive 2 divine rays, or a holy word and divine ray, and the centaur shot, or a djinn shot, which will probably happen unless I totally killed off. The djinn, I don't think I can, so the djinn will probably come here, park himself, and then shoot down, and that would have been that. So yeah, it would not have been enough. Would not have worked. Let's see, who else can I lower down? Let's level up Kai a little bit here first. Just want to see what I can get. Well, he's totally gone. Who can I lower down enough to help out Kai grow? Alright, so he's dead in the water. This thing... maybe... Yeah. Alright, watch this. This will be cool. I won't kill this thing off because 127 from a green, that's going to be a stretch. But 127, he is level 16, 97 was good, but trying to get 127 hit points damage from a high centaur green on another green, that's a stretch. So, alright, I haloed Kai. And I can kill off. Oh man, I want to hit him too. Well, I'm getting two kills with this, or I get two kills with this. Kind of forgot about that part. Oops. Alright, so which one's more devastating to hit? Well, I'd be the centaur. Oh, I was thinking I don't know why. I'm thinking I was able to move to here. I could target this whole thing, but I'm just not far enough away. Oh, yikes. What am I looking at anymore? Jeez. I was hoping I could at least target this, and I would have rung that all up. So what's the best thing here? Yeah, let's go for the angel. Kill that angel off. I mean, probably has some 70. Yeah, I'll break it. I will break you. Genobolt. So I wonder what we'll do with the bishop, though, because I think, like, whoa, 182. Only God and Kai win every time. That's what happens. So, 2,877, yes. So we gotta level up Kai. Kai's gonna take a while. Once we get to like 28 or 29, it's gonna be super easy. Super easy to, get things going the way I want them to go. Oh, that's a level 7 angel. That's what I'm doing. I'm angel hunting right now. I gotta look for these angels. Turn them into fallen angels. Turn them into risen angels, send them back to heaven. Because I can't have them fighting me like this. So, I guess overall I didn't have to worry about the whole bishop thing. But initially that's usually what I do when I'm playing. I'm worrying about, who could die, this and that. And I'm just kind of looking at it from a very, very defensive standpoint. So I can have everybody survive, especially on my main team. My secondary team, I will burn everybody up just to survive. Just to win the castle. But my main team, the one I have to level up, this is what I'm going to focus on. I'm trying to have everybody survive. Even the scorpion survive. Look at that. Scorpion survive. Save the scorpion fun. We got that going for us still. So we got a level 10 giant. Scuba Steve went up. Perfect. So, alright. So that's been a bit of a video. I don't know if I can do another video quick here. That might have to be it for right now. So she's gonna go look for a loot. Okay, so now I quest her, she goes for a loot, and then the other ones they go find everybody else. So let's just look at the map here. I think this is as far as I could go for today. Which wasn't very much, but I did get to I got two battles in here. I was able to defend this. Let's class up these knights here. Or these monsters, I mean. I could level him up. Let's go for a red dragon. They're a little more powerful. I mean, I think the silver dragon's a little more powerful, but I just like the salamanders better. Oh, jeez. What did I do? Alright, so I moved the... Let's see if I can get an angel here, because I'm about to forget about that. I don't think I can here. I think just dragons now. So. Let us move this around. You can go here. I want the fairy on Kai's team. Yeah. We'll go put dragon on the team. Because I don't think this is going to be anything. I don't know how much I can put on here, but I do need the fairy on Kai's team more than I need on anybody else's team. Double Geno Thunders is quite a hell of a thing to have. So we will do that. Save the Scorpion right here. It's level 7. Perfect. Alrighty. So he's up to par. Let's class you up. Let's class you up, buddy. So we are actually, instead of going for a Gigantes, which was the possibility of Loki, we're going to go for Titan. So we're going to try to go for Thor. So let's do that. We gotta, let's class you up to Pegasus here. Unisex is now Pegasus. Unibrow is Pegasus too. What else? Should I give the Red Dragon to this team maybe? Because they kind of need something here. I could still work on other stuff. It's not a problem, really. Oh, that's just too much. I thought that might work, but that's too much. Okay, so we switch it with the green, maybe. That works. Okay, well, I do need an angel. I don't know where I'm going to be able to put it, though. Maybe Percival has to go, or maybe this... Oh, man. Well, he's only level 4. I guess if we get an angel, I'll swap it out with the Wyvern. So that'll probably be enough for that. And, or the dragon. I guess the dragon, I could swap it out for that. I don't need that. So I'm trying to build up his team with some other powerful stuff too. This should be okay. So I got 15 more, so that's 45. It's not, that's too much for a lizard guard. Well, we could still put some strong stuff on the top. I'm gonna need 40 points each for these. I'm gonna need 15, 20 more points for this. So I still will need 80, 100, about 100 here. Let's see what we can equip. Ooh, Dark Emblem, Poison Fang. Should I do that? Doing this for him because he needs to get as strong as possible. Poison Fang and a shield. Alright, well, Shutleis. Well, I already have the egg and shield. I have 2 Poison Fangs. Keep giving me that. I can't do much with that. So, did I get any stock? Another Scorpion. Well, I already have 1. Getting 2 is going to be tough to raise them all the way up to 30. Getting items though. Well, yeah, I've already had that. So that's pretty much it for that. Here's the map. We'll end the video here. I'm sorry, I wanted to do a lot more videos in this episode, this LP that we're doing here. But that's it for that. So yeah, keep voting for Knights and Monsters for the final fight with Bulnoil. And thanks a lot for watching, and I will talk to you later.